I am back with another Get Ready With Me. I wanted to do this video because I want to do an update on how I do my makeup now. Bro, I watched the videos of when I used to do my makeup back then. Back then, they should have stopped me and they should have been like, no, you should do this this way. But at the same time, people would tell me how to do things. I thought I knew better than them, so like I didn't listen. If you were to check out my Instagram or my TikToks too, I barely do any eyeshadow the way I used to do. But I'm slowly want to get back into it because I have a bunch of palettes that are going to waste and I don't want them to go to waste. So yeah, also don't mind my like messy hair. Leave it alone. I'm doing the best that I can, okay? And lately I've been trying to take care of my hair. I want her to look pretty and she so long. I'm trying. First things first is primer. I'm gonna show you all the primers that I have and which ones I use. I sometimes use them all, sometimes I don't. It just depends on my mood and like what I want, if I want it to last all night or not. But yeah, I'm about to show you. Also, I'm gonna have music playing in the background because I can't do my makeup in silence. Oh, you guys wanna see the Halloween nails that I did? If you watched my last video, you kind of like heard me mention that I do nails. This is one of the sets that I did. They're so cute, there's little ghosts. I have the e.l.f. Poreless Putty Primer. And this primer, I only put it right where my pores are at, basically. Pores and blackheads. And then I also have the NYX Professional Makeup, the Marshmallow Primer. I actually really, really love this one. It makes my face even kind of soft. And then I have the e.l.f. Power Grip. I barely ever use this one, though. Change up like I change clothes.
You change up for the main hoes. You asking me to stick around.
I'm gonna apply the putty primer first. And like I said, I just put some where I have pores. And then after that, I go in with the NYX putty primer. And that one, I do put that one all over my face, like if it was lotion. After I do my primer, I learned a trick on TikTok and it kind of like helps do my eyebrows better. They're looking kind of fucked up. Like, okay, my eyebrows always been fucked up, but they're fucked up even more because I cheated on my eyebrow lady. They were getting better. And I went to somebody, I didn't go to somebody else, I went to the same place, just a different lady, and that lady fucked them up. So I'm not going back until she comes back and she's on vacation right now, so I gotta wait. Haki, nilo de mante con saroki. You're gonna outline them like if you were to, if you're cleaning them up after you do them. What I'm doing right now is I'm tapping it and I'm like just blending it in. The pomade that I use for my eyebrows, I feel like you're too far to see what I'm doing. It's the Anastasia one and I use the shade medium brown. Before I do that though, I want to try out the e.l.f. soap brow. I have this Maybelline eyebrow glue. It's not even Maybelline, it's the NYX brow glue. It looks like this. I've been using this one and I actually like it. But I've been hearing a lot of good things about the e.l.f. one. So I'm going to go ahead and test it out today to see if it does what it's supposed to be doing. If I can even open it. Oh my god, it was already kind of open. Should I be scared? Am I supposed to wet it? Did it come with the instructions? Maybe I don't come up with the instructions and I have to wet it. That's so much work. I just came back from work. I'm tired. I don't want to do that extra shit. So we're gonna use our old one. We're gonna use the NYX one. This one, it's the glue's already on there. Just brush your eyebrows to your shape of liking. One thing that I hate the most with me in general is my eyebrows. I always dislike my eyebrows. So what I like to do, as you can see, this like product inside the cap, So I grab a little bit. That's on my brush. Put some right here. And after the product is on the cap, I grab one of my setting sprays. I grab the MAC one, and any setting spray, honestly. You just grab it, you spray it a little bit so it's like wet. And then you kind of like grab the part that you need, and you start going in and doing your eyebrows. I'm not gonna show you doing my eyebrows because, like I said, I don't like my eyebrows, and I wouldn't think I'm the best at doing eyebrows, so I'm not even gonna show you the step. I'm just gonna show you what's after this one, okay? Now that I have my eyebrows on, I hate them. Chiquito mommy. After I do my eyebrows, I move on to my base, and the first thing that I use is the L'Oreal True Match tip. And I use these two to make like my perfect shade or whatever, because one's too light, one's too dark. So I put it on my face, and then I grab a dry sponge and just blend it out. And basically what this does is kind of makes my face into like one neutral color. And this is what I use for my foundation when I don't want to do makeup, when I want like a no makeup makeup look. See how like this matches it perfectly? It doesn't look white or too dark or anything. I then go in with my actual foundation. And today the foundations that I'm going to be using, it's going to be the Rare Beauty in the shade 160C. And then the Anastasia Beverly Hills in the shade 100 and N. You know, Fenty had this perfect, amazing foundation that I fucking love. Pro Filter Hydration Longwear. This was my favorite, and now I think they discontinued it, and I fucking love this one, and I tried looking for one in my shade and nothing. Anyways, I blend my foundation with a wet sponge. Also, I'm kind of glad I am doing my makeup, because now I kind of have an excuse to go out. I'm gonna go get my earring switched out, because I did get a new piercing, so I'm gonna go get that switched out. And I am actually really excited for this, because this lady, she's gonna switch out all my piercings to new ones to make them look connected, and then we might add a few. We might just leave it the way that it is, but yeah, I'm excited. With the same sponge, our dry one that we used in the beginning, we're gonna go ahead and grab that one and just take off some of the axis.
We are looking at how to pronounce these words. How do you say this one? Excess. Excess. Excess.
So we don't look as cakey, to help it also blend in a little better too. I feel like this step actually really helps a lot, at least for me, because now my foundation everything looks like skin. That's just one of my secret steps. It helps me. After that, I'm gonna go in with the Fenty Beauty foundation in the shade 103. Did I tell you what shade? Oh, I didn't even use the Fenty Beauty foundation. Never mind. I'm tripping. And I'm gonna put that under my eye. I'm gonna put it in the corner and the outer corner. And then same thing on this side. And then I'll put it on top of my lip, under my chin, and then some on my forehead. After that, I'm gonna let that kind of sit in a little bit. I'm gonna go in with the cream contour, the Elf's cream contour, and then I'm gonna grab my angled brush that looks just like this, and I'm gonna grab the lightest shade, the dark shade, and then the second to darkest shade, and I'm just gonna work that into my, I'm gonna do a little V at the tip of my nose, like so, and then I'm gonna try to have those lines as close together as possible. Drag it up, and then I'm gonna do some lines on the side to give it like a shadow shape length, just like that, and a little bit on the forehead, just like that. And then with the Rare Beauty concealer in the shade 100C, we're gonna go ahead and put some of that underneath the contour. Just like that. And your face should kind of look something like this. Since I did do my concealer first, I am gonna grab a smaller sponge. I'm gonna grab a small sponge and I'm gonna go ahead and do my under eyes. See how easy that blends? I love Fenty Beauty. After we blend everything, I'm going with the Huda Beauty powder. This is my favorite powder of all time. Like, it's expensive, but it's so worth it. Like, I love it. Like, I love it. That's all I have to say. I love this. Like, if I could, I'll marry it. I'm not really gonna sit. I'm gonna sit, but not sit, if that makes any sense. I'm gonna sit it with my sponge. I just put a little bit. I put it on like my thing and I just like shake it and go again everywhere with it to kind of set everything. After I do that, I go in with my powder contour palette. This one's from Sephora, but just the basic one that they have. Like, literally just say Sephora. For this one, I grabbed an angled brush like this. And then I grab this shade. And a little bit of this one. And to kind of like even it out, I go in with the lighter shade that they have on there. And I don't go in a straight line anymore. I actually tap. I go like this. We tap our skin out. That way it doesn't look like a harsh straight line, if that makes any sense. I forgot to do blush. Because I really do blush, and I was going to do blush, and I forgot to do blush. And I told myself, we're going to do blush today. Yeah, that's not going to happen. At least we can still do blush, we just can't do the liquid blush anymore. Because like if I put some on top right now, it's going to look all cakey and ugly, and I don't want that. And then again, a little bit on the forehead. It's because I feel like I already have a small forehead. I have a big head, but I have a small forehead. So I just like, so it doesn't look like it's like invisible. I just do very, very, very little. And then for my nose contour, I use a completely different brush. I just need something that's like this type of fluffiness, like this. And what I do is grab the same shades that I grabbed before and basically do the same thing. I go like this, but actually outline the whole little like M thing that I have. I'm so happy I don't have burgers because that'll be embarrassing. But the whole M, I go ahead and outline that. I contour that, and then I just bring it in from the tips of the side right there like this, and I go up. I use the cream contour that I did as my guideline. But what you want to do that's different from the cream is that you want to bring it up into your eyebrow, so it gives it like a longer, like it's skinny and longer type of like hallucination. I think that's what it is. An illusion. I don't know the word, but yeah, you know, we women, we catfish people. Same thing, you want to take some and bring some to the side, that way your nose looks tiny. Sometimes I don't even know what the fuck I'm doing. Some days my nose looks worse, sometimes it looks better. It just depends on the day, if I'm being honest. The blush that I want to use today, it's from this brand. I can't say it. It starts with a C. I'm gonna use this blush in the shade Dusk. Dusk, right? That's how you say it. D-U-S-K, Dusk. And I'm gonna like put that on my cheek. And then I'll put some on my nose. I'm gonna add some contour because I'm going with the e.l.f. bronzer because I kind of feel like the blush kind of took some of that away. And I'm just gonna like grab just a random shade. We're just gonna tap that in there like that. And same thing with the other one. I'm gonna grab my setting spray and I'm gonna wet my face. And I'm gonna show you why. I learned this trick on TikTok. I forgot from who, but I saw it on TikTok and, oh, I remember who. I got it from her, if it'll pop up. She showed her little secret one time on TikTok and I decided to take it because it works. Like, bro, it makes your face look like you don't got like too much texture. It makes it look smooth. And with the Huda Beauty Powder, it makes it even look even better, because the Huda Beauty Powder already makes it look like you don't got like no texture on your face. So this is just like a plus. Watch. So first you want to do is wet your face, but you don't want to wet it too much, because then your makeup's going to drip and it's going to come off and it's going to look ugly. So you're just going to like want it to dry up a little bit, but not fully. It's like somewhat dry but somewhat wet. So now what you're going to do is grab some powder and just go in where you normally get like your smile lines or whatever, and just blend that out with like your sponge. But you don't want to apply it right when it's like super wet, because then it's going to look very cakey and very ugly, and we don't want that. Whatever's left, I just got my big fluffy brush and it's kind of just like brush that all off. And now it looks like I have like smooth ass skin. Like, look at that. Looks like we got like nothing on. We're like naturally like this. Like no filter, no nothing. We're not done yet though. Still got a little more to go. I'm gonna do eyeshadow. I'm probably not gonna talk through the process of eyeshadow. If you guys want like a video on eyeshadow and how to do eyeshadow, like how to blend or like or whatnot, I don't know. If you want to look on eyeshadows, I'll do a look on eyeshadows. Like, I mean, look. If you guys want a video on eyeshadows, I'll do one. Like, if you guys want to send me like or comment down like what color eyeshadow I should try, I'll do it. Just like comment down and I'll do it. Usually I always stay in the neutrals. Like, I literally just stay in the neutral for eyeshadows. Like, I want to do a little pop of color. So I'm debating if I want to do neutral colors or a pop of color, like hella colors, or do neutrals and then like do like a little like somewhere, you know, somewhere on there. I think I know what I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna grab my 305 palette by Fierce by Nature by Morphe. It looks just like this, and it has a bunch of pretty warm colors, you know, great for the fall and like Christmas and whatever. This has orangey, some few like top pops of green and pink and stuff. So I'm gonna use this one. And then for this, when I do my eyeshadow, I like using my bigger mirror. I don't like using the little one. I'm gonna grab a shade of brown. It's kind of like browny orangey, which is what I kind of need it to do. So I'm gonna apply it at the top. Okay, I'm gonna rant a little bit because I am annoyed. Today at work, guy came in. He always comes in. And it's always the same thing with him. He's always complaining. It's so annoying. And to everybody, like almost everybody, like had his chance of getting him. And I usually try to avoid getting him. But today it was my turn of getting him. And bro, he made my life a living hell. He was complaining because he didn't understand me. Apparently my accent was too thick for him, which I don't even think I have an accent. And then he was saying, oh, you speak too fast. And I'm like, okay, the speaking fast I get. And then he kept saying that he wanted cherry juice. And I'm like, we don't carry cherry juice. And he's all like, yes, you guys do. And I'm like, no, we don't. He's like, well, what's the red drink that's right there on the picture? And I'm like, oh, that's just like a picture for the machine. Like, we don't carry that. We have orange juice, apple juice, grapefruit and tomato juice. And then he goes, well, you must be new here because I got cherry juice not too long ago. And I looked at him like, it was probably tomato grapefruit because we don't carry cherry juice. I'm like, and he's like, well, you're new here. And I'm like, no, I've been here for 2 years. And he started laughing and he's like, oh yeah, okay. And I'm like, mm-hmm. And I was like already over him, like, bro, I wanted like to leave. So after, you know, I took his order, I asked him like, do you want a menu? He was like, well, I don't understand. He's old. So I was trying to speak loud and he started telling me not to yell at him. And I'm like, I'm not yelling at you, but okay. So I really didn't know what to do. I just, after he ordered, I kind of like left him alone. And I let my, I told somebody, I was like, can you watch him? Well, like, I pick up these other tables because, bro. And they did. He left me a good tip, I'm not gonna lie. But still, like, he made it so hard for me and for himself. I'm like, I wasn't even wearing a face mask. Like, I was like talking to you and you somehow still couldn't hear me or understand me because my aunt's accent was too thick and I was talking too fast. Which I admit, I do talk fast sometimes, and I need to work on like talking slower. Grab a different brush and blend that out. I think all the brown shades have orange to it, and I don't like that. So I'm gonna go in with the palette that I have in my hand right now, which is the BFF palette by BH Cosmetics. It's by Alondra and Elsie, and I'm gonna grab the shade Aloe and Else plus Latte. So I'm gonna grab both of these shades like this. I can't wait for Christmas. I love Christmas time. Everybody's so much nicer sometimes. What else? Oh my god, I love the cold. Like, I can't wait for hot chocolate. I can't wait for hot chocolate. Like, I'm more excited, like, for the hot chocolate. I feel like I have a lot to say, but, like, nothing's coming to my mind right now. Mostly because this video is kind of last minute. And this video was supposed to be a morning vlog. Well, a vlog all day, basically. But, I got called into work. It wasn't bad. Okay, I'm gonna rant a little bit because I am annoyed. Today at work, I'm gonna do green because it's already out here. It goes right into it. That's fine, it's whatever. What did you guys do today? If you guys really knew me, I like going out, but I don't like going out. If that makes sense. I prefer being home. Oh, I just like stabbed my palette. What the fuck? Anyways, back to my story. You know how you have like those friends that you can't really like say no to? I mean, not saying that you can't say no to them, but like, you know, that they encourage you to go out and you feel bad telling them no, so you go. Yeah. That's how I feel like. But I like being at my house. Well, I don't like being at my house either. I'm complicated. I don't know how to explain it. I feel like I'm messing this up. Like, why does it look so fucking thick? Probably because I need lashes. Lashes fixes everything. I'm debating if I want to do a glitter look or not. Under my eye, I'm going to add some yellow. I'm going to go in with the Morphe Star Patch Palette. I feel like I'm going to do pink instead. I don't like that one. You know, a mascara that I've been loving is the Essence. I think that's how you say it. Because, yeah, Essence. And the pink one that I love, Extreme Crazy Valley Mascara. Top notch. I wanted to go get another one. And when I went, they didn't have no more. They ran out. So I know TikTok is selling that shit out. But I found this on the app Flip. It's like a TikTok, but for shopping and reviews. And I'm like, I'm going to go to Ulta and I'm going to buy it before I buy it online. So I think I'm just going to buy it online now. But look at that. Do you see that? I barely put any on. Like, what the fuck? I'm not gonna lie, I kind of bullshitted my eyeshadow. It looks kind of bad. I'm not gonna lie, it looks bad. I think this is just like a little tiny step to getting back into it with the makeup. For the corner of my eye, I do want to add some highlighter. I'm gonna let that sit because I don't want to add mascara, I mean lashes, with while it's still wet, because it's gonna like leave me mascara underneath my eyes. I think I'm gonna do glitter on my face. I love glitter. But this is the Anastasia Moon Child highlighter, and this is just color highlighter. Like, literally there's blue, purple, pink. I think I'm gonna do blue. It's ice blue, so it'll be like there but not really there, if that makes sense. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna whip this flat brush. I'm gonna spray it. I'm gonna get blue eyes and I'm gonna put that on the corner of my eye. Who the fuck? Do you see that? How? Why? How did I do that? I wanna cry. It's not going away. Okay, it kinda went away. But so did my contour. What the fuck? Back to my makeup. I hate when that happens. And I feel like that happens to me daily. Like, what the fuck? I have some green glitters. So I'm thinking of doing green highlighter. Or should I just do neutral? So I don't look too crazy either. But at the same time, I don't give a fuck. After this, I just have to do highlight and just highlight. Oh, and lip gloss. Lip gloss, same thing. I think these eyelashes aren't even mine. They're too tiny. They're tiny. What the fuck? I look, I want to get contacts again. Remember when I used to wear contacts back in high school? And then I moved to Texas. And then people actually thought, like, I was new there, right? So people actually thought I had color eyes. And then one day I went with no contacts, so, like, I forgot. And then this one guy in my class goes, I thought you had color eyes. I'm like, I do. These are just my contacts. And he goes, like, are you serious? And I'm like, yeah. I wish I had color eyes, the fuck. But no, I really want to start wearing eyelashes again. Contacts. I'm gonna start wearing contacts again. It's because I'm doing my lashes and I'm thinking of lashes. See, I like it when I get it on the first try, not on the second or third. Should I just do regular glitters? I think I'm gonna do regular glitters. See, the lashes put the whole look together. Like, without lashes, when I do eyeshadow, I feel like a bald eagle. Like a naked bird. That's what I feel like. But I feel like these are off. Like, they feel off. And I don't want to redo it and take it all off, because then I wasted product for nothing. And I'm not taking it off. I'm just gonna suck it up. Okay, I'm getting distracted, so I'm gonna come right back when I have everything done. Let me just show you what I'm gonna be using. That way you don't get all by it. For highlight, I'm gonna go in with the Fenty Beauty. And I'm using the Lightning Dust and Fire Crystal set. It's really quickly before it dies. This is the final look. On my lips, I have, honestly, I forgot what I used. To outline my lips, I use the Maybelline New York in the shade 699. And then I use the MAC in the Under the Covers 405 to do my lips. And then for the gloss, I use the Lip Pumping by Mulan in the shade 120. And let me tell you, this shit burns. Anyways, I also changed my outfits. I have on some ripped jeans and I'm wearing my, I'm gonna put on my Air Forces right now. I'm barefoot. But yeah, this is the look. I hope you guys enjoy this video and don't forget to like and subscribe. And I'll be back with more videos and hopefully more makeup videos where I'm slowly like trying to get back into doing my makeup again. At least color eyeshadow. It doesn't look bad. Like I thought it was terrible, but it's not that bad. Like everything came out perfect. Not perfect, but it came out good. But yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Bye.